Good evening. Tonight I'd like to share with you both savory and sweet pumpkin recipe. We'll start with this smooth, velvety pumpkin soup that you will fall in love with. You'll need a pumpkin, onion, about 4 medium potatoes, 3 tablespoons of oats, half a cup of heavy cream, paprika, curry, black pepper, and salt. Let's roll in the pumpkin. For both of these recipes, I've used one pumpkin, half for each recipe. I think it's a great way to use up your decorative pumpkins after the season's over. And right now we will clean, cut open, and clean out the seeds out of the pumpkin itself. That's left is peeling and slicing our pumpkin into smaller pieces. We peel our potatoes, cutting out all the little nooks and extras, and slicing them, slice them into smaller sizes. We take a few slices of bread, cut it into small bite-sized chunks. Mm-hmm. Then we dry roast them on a hot pan until they're crisp. Warm up some oil, fry up some onions for about 3 minutes, then add potatoes, pumpkins, and cook for a couple more minutes. Now we'll add about a liter of water. And let it all boil for about 10 minutes or so. Next, we add soaked, washed oats. Add a pinch of salt, black pepper, half a teaspoon of curry, and paprika. Stir and boil another 5 minutes. Now it's time to blend it all in with a handheld blender until silky smooth. Pour in heavy cream. Mix and boil on low for 2 more minutes until all blended. And voila! Your soup is done and ready to eat. I like to top it with the homemade croutons. It makes for a wonderful, hearty, but very good for your health soup this fall or winter. Enjoy. Now on to our delight. It's so lightly sweet, lightly spicy, so good with tea or as a dessert. So you need half of the pumpkin and orange, a couple of sour apples, cranberries, raisins, a little bit of butter, cinnamon, sugar, or honey in my case. We'll need to clean our pumpkin and remove the seeds from it. This time, no need to peel it though. Now it's time to mix the raisins with cranberries. And soaking them in hot water for about 10 minutes. Now on to apples. I'm going to peel them, but you're welcome to keep the skin if you'd like. We'll remove the core. Now we'll slice our orange. We'll be removing the orange peel, leaving just small pieces. Now it's time to fill our pumpkin with all of the wonderful fruits. You can arrange them in any pattern you like. I liked to add cinnamon and honey in between two or three layers to make sure it's nice and soaked. Juicy and sweet. You are, of course, welcome to experiment, adding different fruit, different types of honey, or maybe sugar or brown sugar, all is welcome. Same thing with cinnamon. You're welcome to use any other spice that's sweet to your preference. And then we top it with 20 grams or 2 tablespoons of butter. We're taking our crinkly oven bag. And we'll be placing it inside the bag. put it in a preheated 360 degree Fahrenheit oven or 180 degrees Celsius, and we bake it for 1 hour. And voila, here's your wonderful, very tasty delight made out of pumpkin with fruits that's lightly sweetened but so tasty and tender. You're going to love it. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you so much.